As we're sitting, just coming into the moment gently, just allowing a broad awareness, aware of the sitting posture, and knowing that we're sitting, and just getting a sense for the felt experience of the sitting posture. Aware of your bottom, your thighs touching the carpet, the floor, the cushion, just feeling. Aware of those feelings. And aware of your back, a sense of upright. And your shoulders. Relaxing the shoulders. When we come to meditate, we're aiming for a focused but also a gentle quality of effort. The back is fairly straight but not tense. And we consciously just let go of tension in that shoulder area. It's useful to use the out-breath. You can take a couple of deep in-breaths. And on the out-breath, consciously putting things down for now. It's probably been a long day for many people. Many things to attend to. Many people, many sights, many sounds. And turning the attention inward now. And when we come to do our breath meditation, there's a chance to put down these other things for a while, have a bit of a rest. So whatever happened today, while we're meditating now, we don't need to attend to that. We can just leave the day where it is. Already the past. First come to the cushion. It's good to try to feel the entire in-breath, the nose, the chest and the abdomen. We're trying to feel the physical feeling. Once we've located that physical feeling, then we try to place awareness on that feeling and then on the physical feeling of the out-breath. Noticing the breath as it comes in at the nose, down through the chest, and into the abdomen. And then as it leaves the abdomen, the chest, and the nose. If it's helpful, you can use mental noting, counting. Noting one at the nose, two at the chest, three at the abdomen. And then three at the abdomen, two at the chest, one at the nose. When we use mental noting, we're giving the thinking mind a task, which can help restrain it from other thoughts. One, two, three. Three, two, one. when we're training in mindfulness, we're practicing noticing feelings in the body as just being feelings, and thoughts as just being thoughts, without adding anything else. So when we come to the cushion, there usually is a sense of self, living in a world, thinking about the past, worried about the future. All of this is something that we add, which is normal. When we come to the cushion, it's a chance to put things down, have a break from the world, have a break from being somebody, and have a break from other people too. We're just placing awareness on the breath and trying to establish a cool center in the middle of experience, aware of the in-breath, 1, 2, 3. Aware of the out-breath, 3, 2, 1. Similarly, we can use the word buddho. Bud on the in-breath, do on the out-breath, whichever you prefer. The Buddha was the one who knew the truth without confusion, the one who was awake, undeluded, completely at ease and peaceful. So we practice knowing the in-breath and knowing the out-breath, and putting everything else down. Gently placing awareness on those feelings, feeling of the in-breath and the feeling of the out-breath. Mindfully aware of breathing. And trying to rest if you can in the spaces between the in and out breaths, keeping the mind within the parameters of the body. Not thinking about other places, other people, the past, the future. the world that we see with our eyes can often seem so solid and so real. But it's interesting when we allow awareness to rest with the breath and put down thoughts, close the eyes, and the world is gone. Similarly, we perceive our bodies and our thoughts as very solid, very real. But if we can keep our mindful awareness with the breath, we also might notice a sense of spaciousness in the body, that sense of solidity, relaxing. One in-breath, one out-breath. In just this moment, Just trying to be mindful for a few more minutes of the feeling of the breath, the in-breath and the out-breath. Putting down to the degree that you can all other things. And giving a quality of interest and a quality of care. Offering this interest, offering this caring to this physical sensation. We want to try to know the in-breath and know the out-breath very intimately, very closely. Without any critical perceptions, without any judgments. And dropping all of that. Allowing the body to be just as it is, quality of acceptance, and allowing the breath to be just the way it is, simply knowing. And placing this awareness with care. And then relaxing also, relaxing into this awareness. Gently aware of each in-breath. Mindfully attentive to each out-breath. Now this experience of living in a world, of perceiving this body and these thoughts as a self, and perceiving others as a self, is fairly painful and a frustrating experience. And so it's good also when we calm the mind to try to offer some loving kindness on this deeper level of the mind, this sensitive part of the mind, underneath all of the activity, underneath all the thoughts, there's a sensitive mind there, quite possibly feels a little bit bruised or a little bit sore. This is also normal, but it's quite helpful to, in a manner of speaking, bathe this level of the mind, wash the mind with some kindness, with some warmth, with some love. So we just, also using the in and the out breath, without thinking very much, we just offer this warmth, we offer this kindness, we offer this love. We can also use words, and breathing in, make the wish, may I be well. And just allowing an accepting, kind, human warmth to arise in the heart area. And on the out-breath, may I be happy. And breathing in, and bringing in a fresh sense of light and of energy. No, we're not bringing it in from outside. Kind of bringing it forth, inviting it out of our own minds. This loving kindness or metta is right there actually, just needs to be generated. So when we're breathing in, generating this warmth, this kindness, may I be well. One of the ways to generate this sense of kindness is just to offer an attitude of acceptance. So to whatever we have been thinking, whatever we have been feeling, in our ordinary human confusion, not judging that, offering an attitude of kindness, may I be well, And we can use the out breath when breathing out, may I be happy, and drop all of the judgments. So breathe in, we allow this warmth, this kindness to fill the area of the chest. May I be well. May I be happy. Dropping all of the stories, not even thinking of the past. Just offering that attitude of love, of kindness, of human warmth in this moment, this new moment. Starting again. Breathing in, may I be well. Breathing out, may I be happy. So breathe in, we allow this warmth, this kindness to fill the area of the chest. And if possible, you can fill more of the body with this feeling of goodwill. A sense of bathing the experience of the body with an energy of kindness. And breathing out, may I be happy. If you don't particularly feel any warmth, that's okay too. We have to be patient with the process, we have to be patient with our minds. But at the very least, we offer this wish. this kind wish. May I be well. May I be happy. And now once again just coming back to the feeling of the breath and practicing mindfulness of the feelings of the breath. Sometimes when we offer some loving kindness in that heart area, it can be calming. We sometimes find that it's easier to be mindful of the breath after practicing loving kindness. It's another tool that we can use in training our minds. You can offer this attitude of kindness, this attitude of interest, this attitude of non-judgment to just knowing that breath. Knowing those feelings, aware of the in-breath at the nose, the chest and the abdomen. And aware of the out-breath, abdomen, chest, nose. We'll just go for 5 more minutes, I won't say anything else. But just really try to be aware of that breath. And relax into that awareness. just one more minute to go. If you like, you can bring to mind another person you want to dedicate some merit. Practicing meditation generates some good karma. You can consciously dedicate that positive energy to another person if you like, either living or having moved on. And may that person, may that being also be well. May they be happy.